What just happened now was typical Scott Carpenter. Just before we came up here, Scott said, "Coach, I have to follow that guy?" I have the privilege of presenting Scott Carpenter, the Ripon College Hall of Famer. Scott came to us from Ripon High School, where he led Ripon High School to a state championship. At Ripon College, Scott dominated the Midwest Conference for 4 years. He was the best pitcher in the league from the first day till the day that he graduated. He was all-conference, freshman, sophomore, junior years. Senior year, he was a player of the year in the Midwest Conference. He was all-region. I believe it was 3 out of 4 years. Scott is still among the leaders in several categories in the Midwest Conference. When Scott pitched, I don't know who had an easier job than I had. I never took Scott out from any game that he pitched at Ripon College. I did go out to the mound once. As I walked out, Scott had this very surprised look on his face. "Coach, are you okay?" I laughed on the inside, but what I told Scott is, I said, "Scotty, the reason that I came out here was for our fans. I just wanted them to know that I was awake in the dugout." Scott won 24 games for Ripon during his career. It was the third most, it is the third most in school history. But that is a little misleading. During Scott's time at Ripon, the brilliant Midwest Conference only allowed us to play 24 baseball games at that time. Today, Ripon plays 40 regular season games plus tournaments. I often wonder how many games would Scott Carpenter have won if we would have played 45 games in a year. Would he have won 40, 45? I'm really not sure. Another highlight of Scott's career was beating St. Norbert's every time he pitched. He was 7-0 against St. Norbert's. I think he beat him 1-0 like 4 times. One time that I thought was really comical, I'll never forget it. Scott's senior year, we're in the conference tournament. They play at two sites. In the first, we were playing Knox at Knox, and St. Norbert's was playing Alumni College, I believe, at Monmouth. So nobody really knew what was going on at the other game. So what that meant was, St. Norbert's had no idea who was pitching the first game for Ripon. We won, they won. So now we're in the winner's bracket game, which is in a double elimination tournament. This next game is the biggest game of the tournament. We pulled in to Monmouth, and I've never had this happen. A St. Norbert coach was waiting maybe 5 feet away from our bus. I had no idea. We got off the bus, and the coach from St. Norbert's, he didn't want to be too obvious. He said, "Coach, are you pitching a righty or a lefty in this game?" Scott was left-handed. Again, I laughed on the inside. I said, no, we're not pitching a righty. Scott Carpenter's pitching. Game over. They could not beat Scott. Scott was his last game that he pitched at Ripon. He beat St. Norbert's 17-0. Pitched a one-hitter, and I believe he struck out 13 batters. I can't tell you how proud I am of Scott. For one main reason, I know how much he loved Ripon College. He enjoyed every minute he was here. I know how proud he is that he graduated from Ripon College. Scott has a wonderful life. Now, he has a great family, great wife. I know he is a great father. I know he's a great husband, and I know he's a success in the business world. Mr. President, I'm honored to present Scott Carpenter to the Ripon College Hall of Fame.
Thank you for the next half hour. I'll give you a speech. No, but again, thank you, Coach. It's been a pleasure to play for you, and also want to congratulate all the other nominees and the award winners. But you know what, and thank you to the Ripon College Association Board of Alumni for giving me this award. Really do appreciate it. And you know, and thank you, Coach Gillespie, again, for recruiting me to come to Ripon College. I would also like to thank my mom, my sister, Mary Jo, Patty, my immediate family over there, Gary, Judy, Jill, everybody for showing up, my beloved wife, Gina, 19 years on Tuesday, thanks for putting up with me, my two wonderful boys, Nick and Andy, okay? Love you guys, thank you very much. And I would also like to say that, you know, although this is an individual award, I know we all talk about teams, but I really mean it. I had a really good cast of teammates for my 4 years here at Ripon College. And we all know that Harrison Ford went to Ripon College, played Han Solo, and, you know, Indiana Jones, okay? Pretty cool, but he's, you know, that's what he's known for. But you know what, let me give you the cast of teammates that I had at Ripon College, okay? So the 4 years that I was here at Ripon College, you know, the class of teammates that I had, their names, which is, to me, is just wonderful. I played with Rambo. Frosty, which is AKA, he was our chauffeur. Giggles, Buckets, Meat, Big Mac, Hoagie, Hardcore, Doughboy, and Little E, sometimes called Ewok. Alright, so those are just the nicknames that we had at Ripon College. You can just imagine the laughs that we had in the dugout, just the games that we've had. By having that, just the game is just the fun, okay? And you win as a team, you lose as a team. But it's just how you play together as a team and who are the guys behind you and who you're playing with. That's what it's all about. These individual awards are great, but you know, it wouldn't happen without those guys. You know, without my teammates. And that's truly, I accept this award on their behalf as well. But the more traditional names are like Lanny, Petey, Bass, Grammer, Botus, Younger, Matthew, who I went to high school with. And then another high school friend of mine I got to play college baseball with, Todd Bitsky or Dubinsky. So I mention these names not for the humor, but for the fact that they really impacted my life here as good teammates and friends that I got to play the game with. You know, I'm the one up here standing for the reward, which is great. But again, thank you guys for being my teammates. Being a native of Ripon, as a kid, Ripon College, you can never get away from it. As far as the athletics, it's always in the paper, always seeing the guys around the street. And I grew up in Ripon, so I'd always look at the athletes and it's like, man, that guy's like a football player. Baseball player, basketball player. And then we were always gym rats because Scott Young's father, Doc Young, we'd always go to the gym during the week. And we'd always see Keely coaching. You know, it was Coach Gillespie. You know, I always wanted to play for him. You know, so to have the opportunity was fantastic when he recruited me because he was like the celebrity in my eyes. So to have the opportunity to play for Coach Gillespie was fantastic. Thank you for everything you have done for me and my family. Thank you, Ripon College, for everything that you've given me. And again, I'm truly blessed and honored and humbled. Thank you.